What's up, guys? Today's video is on the top 5 best 1440 pixels, 144Hz monitors. So I made the list from personal opinion, in hours of research, and I've included different options for every type of buyer. As always, all links to the product mentioned in the video will be in the description box, down below. Like the video, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. So, here are the top 5, best 1440 pixels 144Hz monitors. The fifth product on our list is Viotech GN27DB 27-inch gaming monitor. This is our pick for the best budget 1440 pixels 144Hz monitor. It is available for around $290. It measures with stand 24 inches by 18 inches by 10 inches and weighs as little as 10.36 pounds. The display is 27 inches. The Viotech GN27DB is based on Samsung's vertical alignment panel with a superior contrast ratio of 3000 to 1, true 8-bit color depth with 85% NTSC color gamut, 110% sRGB, a 250 nit peak brightness, wide 178 degree viewing angles, and a 5 milliseconds response time speed. Other available features include standard adjustments such as contrast brightness, sharpness, color temperature, gamma 3 presets, 6-axis hue saturation, aspect ratio, and response time overdrive. The display is thin, measuring only 0.7 inches thick, and the screen bezels are thin too, at only 0.3 inches wide on the sides and 0.7 inches wide along the bottom. On the bottom edge of the display are 5 buttons, 1 to power on the display and 4 to control the OSD. It also supports AMD FreeSync, which provides a variable refresh rate if you have a compatible graphics card. The Viotech GN27DB FreeSync range is 40 to 144Hz, so as long as your frames per second is within that range, there will be no screen tearing or stuttering. FreeSync works over both DisplayPort and HDMI, so you can use it with the Xbox One as well. It works with compatible NVIDIA cards too over DP. Connectivity options include DisplayPort 1.2, HDMI 1.4, HDMI 2.0, and 2 3-watt integrated speakers, but no audio line-out port. The screen has a curvature of 1800R, which does slightly increase the immersion but isn't necessary at this screen size. Some of the pros for this product include FreeSync support, fully ergonomic stand, 1 millisecond MPRT response time, 144Hz refresh rate, decent image quality after color calibration. However, a con for this product, the monitor needs color tweaking initially. All in all, the Viotech GN27DB is an outstanding gaming monitor for the price. In fourth place, we have another budget monitor, Pixio PX329. At this time, you can get it at around a maximum of $300. The display itself cuts a thin profile, the top half of the display measures only 0.4 inches thick, and the bottom half houses the display's internals and bumps out to roughly 1.5 inches thick. The screen bezels are thin, measuring only 0.5 inches thick on the sides and top and only 0.6 inches thick on the bottom. Probably the best current value of all VA 1440p monitors, the Pixio PX329 is a flat 32-inch, ultra-slim monitor, with an incredible refresh rate of 165Hz, a contrast of 3000 to 1, and a screen that features great uniformity between brightness, colors, and contrasts across its entire panel. Compatible with both G-Sync and FreeSync, though only at up to 144Hz, the Pixio PX329 has a 5 milliseconds gray to gray response time, 8.27 milliseconds measured by Hardware Unboxed, and an incredibly low benchmarked input latency of only 10 milliseconds, including average response time. It also has an excellent 178 degree viewing angle, so its picture does not lose quality depending on where you view the monitor from. The PX329 is also gaming console compatible, as it has a variable refresh rate that can be scaled down to 120Hz, for current generation consoles. While you have the display turned around, you'll find 4 video ports, 2 DisplayPort 1.2 ports and 2 HDMI 2.0 ports, and a headphone jack on the rear panel. USB ports are nowhere to be found. Also on the back panel is a small joystick button for navigating the display's OSD. Navigating the OSD menu takes a few minutes to get accustomed to because unlike most OSD menus that are positioned along the right edge, this OSD runs along the bottom, which means instead of moving the joystick to the right to make a selection, you move it down to select. Some of the pros of this product include, highest refresh rate at 165Hz, large 32-inch display, slim and lightweight design. However, a con for this product, the 2-year warranty is decent, but there are longer options on the list. Additional features include an eye saver mode, which reduces blue light to minimize eye strain, a tilting monitor stand, VESA mounting compatibility, as well as two DisplayPort 1.2 slots, two HDMI 2.0 slots, and one audio out jack, so you can connect the monitor to a headset or third-party speaker since integrated speakers are not included. The third product on our list is Acer Nitro XV340CK. It is available at around $450. The Acer Nitro XV340CK is a great ultra-wide gaming monitor. It delivers a great gaming experience that feels smooth and responsive thanks to its low input lag and high refresh rate. Its excellent response time makes fast-moving content look crisp, and it has an optional black frame insertion feature to improve motion clarity further. The monitor boasts a slim design with ultra-thin bezels at the top and at the sides of the screen, while the stand offers a good range of ergonomics including height adjustment, 360-degree swivel, -5 degrees by 35 degrees tilt, and 100 by 100mm VESA mount compatibility. The screen has a matte anti-glare coating which eliminates reflections without making the picture grainy. Connectivity options are abundant as well and include two HDMI 2.0 ports, two DisplayPort 1.4 inputs, a headphones jack, dual 3W integrated speakers, and a dual USB 3.0 hub. FreeSync is supported natively to help minimize screen tearing, and it's compatible with NVIDIA's G-Sync. Its ultra-wide format provides plenty of screen space for multitasking, and it even has a picture-in-picture mode that lets you display two input sources at once. Based on a 34-inch and 3440 by 1440 IPS panel, the monitor delivers a rich pixel density of 110 pixels per inch, as well as accurate colors and 178 degrees wide viewing angles. Some of the pros for this product include excellent response time, VRR support, good ergonomics, large screen size and high resolution. However, a con for this product, viewing angles aren't as good as other IPS monitors. Get ready to settle in for those long gaming sessions. By utilizing Acer Blue Light Shield and flickerless technologies, protect your eyes from unnecessary strain and fatigue so you can do even more before you take a break. The second product on our list is Razer Raptor WQHD. The Razer Raptor 27-inch is a great 1440 pixels gaming monitor. It is available for around $700. The Razer Raptor 27 is a very good 27-inch display for 1440 pixel gaming. It gets pretty bright and has a broad enough color gamut to make your games pop, and it's packaged in a striking design. It has an impressive design with the outstanding build quality, a unique and impressive cable management system, and Razer's signature RGB lighting feature in the base. The Razer Raptor 27 is a non-glare 27-inch IPS display featuring 2560 by 1440 resolution, a 420 nits peak luminance, a 1000:1 contrast ratio, and a 1 millisecond ULMB response time, all of which is fairly typical for an IPS QHD gaming monitor nowadays. A more unique feature of the Raptor 27 is its internal 10-bit dimming processor that, as its name suggests, controls the backlighting. It also has great peak brightness and can display a wide color gamut, delivering a decent HDR gaming experience. To say Razer's first gaming monitor goes above and beyond in the style department would be an understatement. This is one of the best-looking monitors we've ever seen. Plus, it checks all boxes specs-wise: a 144Hz refresh rate, FreeSync and G-Sync compatible, an IPS panel, QHD resolution, HDR, and DCI-P3 extended color. Sporting some serious build quality, the Raptor 27 is a fantastic first effort for Razer. Some of the pros for this product include excellent HDR contrast, saturated color, near 100% DCI-P3 coverage, FreeSync and G-Sync compatible, 144Hz refresh rate. However, a con for this product: user must manually switch between SDR and HDR modes. The real star here is the styling and build quality, which goes beyond most of the gaming monitors. There's shockingly little plastic here. The pedestal style base is all metal, made from a solid forged piece. The back of the panel is covered with expensive feeling fabric, and the RGB lighting glows softly around the base, casting a colorful glow on the desktop. And coming in the first place, we have the Asus TUF Gaming VG27BQ. This is our pick for the best overall 1440 pixels 144Hz monitor. You can get it for around $380. This is a very competitive offering in today's market, especially for the 165Hz refresh rate and feature set. The ASUS TUF VG27AC is an impressive 27-inch, 1440p monitor with excellent gaming performance. Thanks to its IPS panel, the image remains accurate at an angle, but blacks look gray in a dark room. It delivers a very responsive gaming experience thanks to its remarkably low input lag, and it has a very fast refresh rate that improves the overall appearance of motion. It also supports FreeSync variable refresh rate technology to reduce screen tearing. The TUF VG27AC has the same style as most other ASUS gaming monitors. It has a square-shaped base with some red on it. It's designed as a gaming monitor but doesn't stand out in an office environment. The next factor is it includes a feature called ELMB Sync, which for the first time allows you to use adaptive sync variable refresh rates and blur reducing backlight strobing at the same time. The design includes a highly adjustable stand. We're getting the works, with height, tilt, swivel, and pivot support. The range of height adjustment is above average, and it's great to get enough pivot support to use the monitor in portrait orientation. There is a VESA mount available as well in case you need it. Despite all the adjustments, the stand is sturdy and doesn't wobble much. Ports are standard stuff. Two HDMI 2.0 and a DisplayPort, with the HDMI ports being limited to 144Hz. If you want to access 165Hz, you'll need DisplayPort. And yes, this is a 165Hz monitor. Some of the pros for this product include, uses ASUS iCare technology, extreme low motion blur tech, shadow boost tech improves contrast, DisplayPort and HDMI support. However, a con for this product, on-screen display is hard to navigate. Crosshairs, timers, FPS counters, shadow boosting and blue light filters are some of the major inclusions, plus of course, ELMB sync for backlight strobing. More mid-range and budget options often don't bother with decent feature sets, but ASUS is keeping the VG27AC strong in this regard. Thank you for watching it. And that's all for now. Hope to see you now in the next video. Till next time, see you guys later.